welcome to the channel. The Mooney today, just doing a maintenance test flight on the turbocharge system. We have been cleared to 16,500 feet currently, and we're just climbing out through...
Pop Echo, just for my planning purposes, tell me again what your plan is. I've got you flight planned over the Wyerton VOR and back. Are you planning on any approaches or anything like that?
No approaches, just heading out towards Wyerton, as I said, just to do some maintenance checks on the turbocharge system. Once we've completed those, we'll be turning around and heading back to Peterborough Airport.
November Pop Echo, understood, thank you.
Yes, we've been cleared up to 16.5. I'm just starting to bring the turbo on now, as we're down to 23 inches of manifold pressure. We're just coming up on 7,000 feet. We're climbing at about 125 indicated right now. We'll be doing 700 feet a minute. Got 34 gallons of fuel on board when we left, about 60 pounds of baggage, and just myself. Just slowly opening up that wastegate so I don't get a sudden surge. It's got to flip a trap door against the inflowing air in the airbox, so it does tend to kind of all of a sudden grab. We're going to be getting pretty close there. There we go, and we feel the boost. Nice. So we're 16,500 feet. We're level. We're indicating about 135 knots on the airspeed indicator. That's giving us a true airspeed of 177 knots. I'm fighting a 59-knot headwind right now. Now, we've got a bit of leakage in our turbocharger setup in the airbox, I'm assuming, which is a common problem with these, because I'm now only able to maintain 26 inches of manifold pressure, and max would be 27 up to 25,000 feet. So we've already started to lose manifold pressure, so we're wide open on the wastegate, and we're now limited to 26 inches. So a little bit of work and attention maybe around that airbox, see if we can tidy up a few things. For the last 2,000 feet of the climb, I had to reduce the climb rate to about 300 feet a minute and increase the indicated airspeed. We were approaching 450 degrees on the CHT. That is a complaint with the aircraft about it getting hot. We're full rich on the mixture to keep temperatures down.
Contact arrival now, 128.8.
So, we sure are moving, but it's a lot of fuel to be burning for not a massive increase in speed. Right now, I'm just in the yellow arc, so I've got the cowl flaps closed as I've got an airspeed limitation on them, and I'm sitting at about 410 Fahrenheit cruise on the CHT, and that's with an outside air temperature of just below freezing. We are only grounding 120 knots with our 60-knot headwind. That's quite something. That really is quite something. So, pretty happy with that, really, for the most part, but I think a bit of improvement could be made there. This model is missing the sort of initial cowling mod that most of the early ones got. I think that's going to become absolutely mandatory to keep our CHT and oil temperatures down.
November Papa Echo, clear direct to Peterborough Airport is approved, and descent down to 12.5 or below is also approved.
Roger that for November Papa Echo. We're just going to start a descent right for 2,000 feet, and we should be there by the time we get to Peterborough.
November Papa Echo, roger.
Wow, that is just gorgeous. I don't think we can make it a full stop. I think we got to do a touch and go. Look at that sunset. Okay, final landing check. Make sure it's prop high RPM for the go around. Here, on latch one green, we're landing on land. Flaps are set at full. One Pappy. Got two Pappies. Peterborough traffic, November Papa Echo, short final, 2-7, touch and go, Peterborough. Yeah, we gotta go down and try that again. That's just far too nice to stop after one. Plus it's freezing cold outside. A little too much speed, so I floated a bit, but very happy with actual landing itself.